cricket test match or test series in England, when someone says, how's that, that's all it's going to be. There is no decision review system that's going to be working, unlike other test matches or matches, and the umpire's word will be final. The question we are asking today is this something that's going to work?
As it is, it's not that we are not using the technology. We have the third umpire who's sitting around, in the room, outside the ground. And in case of doubt, his services are definitely utilized. So similarly, I think TRS should be definitely considered.
Now, because the Indian board has not agreed to the decision review system,
it's boomeranged on them.
Sometimes it's not boomeranged on them. Mm-hmm. The problem is not about the boomeranging or not. The problem, according to me, is the decision review system is followed by certain countries and not followed by other countries.
My only question on this is, and maybe to both of you, is that the premise for this is that most umpiring, therefore, is on balance off the mark.
No. Just to give you a little, very quickly, a snapshot. Earlier, umpires were the, final authority. Then it was found when the sport became very competitive. And, people said, no, if England goes to Australia and is playing with Australian umpires officiating, there is the chance of home country bias. Now the home bias has gone, but human error has come in.
Okay.
And because the stakes are so high, winning or losing means so much in terms of actual prestige, personal pride and the money, that they said, let's eliminate human error as much as possible.